Welcome to the students of final year BPA. I will be discussing about business skill development course 5, which is about field study. So this I will explain with a sample report writing. There are certain essential elements which you have to include in your record book and you have to know the structure of it. So this video will help you to understand the contents and the structure with a sample. So let us take an example of a title, which is about a study on customer satisfaction towards online shopping. So when you select a field study, you have to first find out on what topic you're doing your field study. So now the most common topic is to check about online marketing experience. So you can choose a study on customer satisfaction towards online shopping. So this will be your title. And to move forward, once you're finalized with the title and carry forward your field study, in your report, you have to write about introduction. So our topic is about online shopping. So you will write the meaning of what is online shopping and since when online shopping has emerged, that is World Wide Web, how merchants have moved on from offline to online shopping. And you will also write more about customer shopping experience. You will write about various websites on which customers prefer shopping. And we have to decide whether you're going to write about Amazon, Flipkart, or any popular website of your choice. So that you will be writing in the introduction aspect. The next element is you have to write the objectives. Objectives can be 4 or even 6, but you can also restrict to 3 objectives. So remember, minimum should be 3, maximum can be 4 to 6 in rare case. So with regard to the title, what we are discussing, the objective of the study is to find out the satisfaction level of the customer for online purchase. The next objective, to know the specific reasons for which customers purchase online shopping, to find out the consumer satisfaction level for services provided by the online shopping. Once we have the objectives, for every objective, you need to have 4 to 5 questions in your questionnaire. So let's limit only to 3 objectives. Next is, what is the scope of the study? And here the scope of the study is area which it is going to have an application. So this will help us to understand the brand loyalty, to know about which purchase type people prefer most, to find out the reason for buying specific products, and to find out the price range or discount that people prefer the most. So that becomes the scope of the study. Limitations. No study is left without disadvantages. So there are certain limitations. As we are doing research only in area confined to Bengaluru, so the study is limited only to Bengaluru city. Next, it is based on the consumer shopping experience online. The data collected for the research is fully based on primary data, or you can also limit only towards secondary data. So there are chances of personal bias or personal favoritism. So the accuracy is not true. So due to shortage of time and other constraints, we have limited the study for only 50 people or 50 respondents. The next element in your field study is you have to write about research methodology. Methodology means steps. So the research design used for the study is purely descriptive. Descriptive research studies are those which are concerned with describing the characteristics of either a particular individual or group. And it is with specific prediction, and we will explain the narration of facts and characteristics either related to an individual or situation. Therefore, the research methodology in which we are taking up the study is descriptive in nature. So you have to write a paragraph about descriptive research. Next is, we will be writing about the sample size. Respondents means the people from whom you're collecting data. So we cannot collect data from the entire population. So what we do, we select or restrict the number of people. So in this study, we have restricted to 50 people. So the questionnaire will be sent to only 50 people. So sample size, this refers to the number of the items to be selected from the total population to constitute the sample. And the sample size used for the present study is 50. Now, how do you design your sample? See, we cannot, since you're a student, you cannot go and collect from all the professionals. So what you do is you will take convenient sampling. So with whomever you are accessible, maybe your neighbors, your friends or classmates, you will select those people and identify those 50 samples. So we call this as convenient sampling. statistical tools. So we are going to use very simple statistical tool, which is percentage analysis, as well as ranking analysis. These are very simple, basic statistical tools which students can use for research. So now let's understand how we are going to analyze the data. So I will show you some examples of analyzing data with regard to online shopping experience. So data analysis, we can have questions in your questionnaire relating to gender, male, female. So number of respondents, 29 and 21. So total is 50. Out of 50, 58% are male, 42% is female. Age is below 20 years, 25 to 30 years, 31 to 35, above 35. So you get the number of respondents. Number of respondents total should not exceed 50 because your sample size is 50. So simple calculation with regard to percentage. Location, since we are focusing on Bengaluru, maybe some students are from their hometown, village, city. So they will give those details. So that percentage will be calculated. And profession, it can be student, business, service, professional, or you can use one more column as other. If you are interested to know about their qualification, you will ask educational related questions. So how many are from school, graduate, postgraduate, illiterate? So you will have these columns. For every aspect, you will have a table and graph. Right? So your total will not exceed 50. Next, family status, you can ask nuclear or joint if it's required, and seer. 28 plus 22 is to 50, and then the percentage is calculated. Monthly income, then online websites. You can add some more websites also of your choice. Here we have included Flipkart, Amazon, eBay, Myntra, Snapdeal, OLX, and others. If you say others, they can specify. Then how did you get to know the sources of awareness? Online, offline, friends, newspaper, television. And what products have they purchased? Electronics, mobiles, computers, home appliance, games, garments, footwear, watches, jewels, men's, grocery also. If you can, you can include. We have not included here. So that will be the next question. Preference. Why do you buy online? Is it time saving? Is it because of available information? It is less stress, less expensive, best offers and discount, helpful for old and disabled people, service. Now everybody shops online. So you can think and give options here. Next, do you visit retail stores? Yes or no? How frequently you purchase? Daily, weekly, monthly, yearly? And how do you pay? So these are the questions. And you can go to the next objective. You want to know the level of satisfaction. So these are the questions relating to level of satisfaction. Choice of availability of products, facts considered before online shopping. And see, depending on what topic you choose, these questions you can ask. It's only a sample. So to make you understand what all can be included in questionnaire. Okay, so once this is done, you have to write findings. See, for every table, you have to draw a chart. Below chart, you will write findings. So hence, it is concluded that majority of the respondents are male. And whichever is higher, we are going to specify. So majority of the people in the respondents, we have got the age group is 25 to 30. That is 50%. So you will write for every table like these, you have to write the findings. So you will highlight about majority. Okay. And then after that, you have to write a conclusion. So in conclusion, you will say what is the benefit of online shopping, and it can be in one paragraph or three paragraphs. And finally, you have to write the references, books, journals which you have used. So this video is definitely going to help you to know the structure. But each one of you have a choice to decide on what topics you can do. So this is one of the example of study on online shopping experience. So you have to remember the objectives and the structure. So I will come out with more number of examples, even with questionnaire, which will help you to learn and do your field study better. Thank you all.